Welcome everybody here to your third and final day of the international group stages, where we were going to have Moscow 5 going up against DK until Moscow 5 decided to forfeit both of the games to DK and said, let's just go through to the playoffs. EG versus CLG, however, is running along, so we're going to jump ourselves inside the game. Well, actually not inside the game, we're going to cast off Dota TV because the game started without us, obviously because we weren't meant to cast this one. So we are here, myself, everyone, and Slash, and we are going through the draft already. Should we go power draft?
I think you have no other choice, really.
There is no other choice. We have to power draft because we're behind the eight ball right now, guys. So let's run through very, very quickly. We have Naga, Prophet, Jhen, Tide, Lashrak, Darkseer, Lycan, as well as Brewmaster all being banned out so far. CLG so far picking up Rubick, Morphling, as well as SK coming up for them. Invoker, Enigma, and Lone Druid coming up by EG with one ban left to go for either side.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see what we're going to. Of course, we will always be happy to cast a Morphling when I always in the team.
I love Morphling, man. I love Morphling.
Do you love Lone Druid?
I do love Lone Druids, man. Owie made me fall in love with the Big Bear, man. I never really...
What, just because of a Maelstrom build?
Yeah, that was it. I liked it. He told me outside the box, and the Manta style on the Broodmother, man. I liked it.
By the way, have you looked at all the stats from day two, as in like hero picks and how successful they have been?
Don't tell me Enigma's actually at the top of that.
Actually, he is. Enigma got a lot better. I think the only reason is because... The LGD played him, I think, like three times or something, so suddenly just all shoots up. LGD have not lost a single gap yet so far, so... Certainly good. Another bounty hunter ban. Someone want to enlighten me on that one?
It's just the offlane. So many teams just keep on playing it. I think it's the only reason why it's getting banned. When you start looking at the offlane options of EG, you just remove it out. Any team in Europe and America, they play it all the time. So... Bounty Hunter, easy ban if you want to take out the offlaner. But then again, there's Windrunner still in the pool.
Everybody loves a ginger.
Everybody does love a ginger. Unless you hate a ginger, then obviously you don't love a ginger.
Well, that's a bit obvious, isn't it?
Yeah, because gingers have souls.
No, they don't. Everybody knows that's a lie. On the other hand, there's one hero that Counter Logic Gaming might be picking up. That's a Broodmother. They picked the SK themselves, so there's no real counter since the Tide Hunter is banned out by them. Mm-hmm. So Broodmother would possibly be a very good pick here, since none of those heroes currently on the EG side really has an AoE ability. Invoker certainly does later on in the game if he decides to go for Quas Wex. But certainly a Broodmother pick I think would be really, really good here. Let's see if CLG are gonna pick it up, since Sandkin and Rubick can both function as supports if need be. They're eating into the extra time though, so not 100% sure about this.
Mm-hmm.
They're gonna go with Beastmaster, so that's one more core hero
EG's
to be picked up.
Turn to pick.
And so for CLG, it works easy for them, but so many times in this competition, we have seen Beastmasters having so much success, but we've also seen Beastmasters really shut down at the same time, not getting the level 6 up early, and most importantly, they can't Ancient Stack. All it takes is a couple of Sentry Wards. It's one thing which I think LGD has been really great at. In fact, all the Chinese teams, they're looking for those Ancient Stacks, because more than likely they've done their homework, and it's been like a backbone of so much Europe as well as American Dota, that these stacks just give you such a big burst straight away.
Yeah, and CLG still might be picking up the Broodmother though. It's not out yet. It's not completely out of the picture if Sandkin and Rubick go support. So they possibly could go for the Broodmother, but let's see what EG's last pick is going to be.
10 seconds.
If Enigma... Keeper of the Light.
CLG's turn.
Coddle selection, man. Coddle selection.
I'm a bit surprised here because none of those heroes are really, really needing the mana from Chakram Magic. And they don't have a... heavy push.
It's Coddle offlane.
Possibly.
It's Coddle offlane.
Is a demon Coddle offlane, you think?
No, just Coddle.
Just being Coddle.
Just a solo Coddle offlane, man. Enigma the jungle, Shadow Demon supporting Lone Druid. Yeah.
Fire my laser.
That's all you're... Really? You just sound... What did you just sound like then?
What, like the guy who actually says it?
Really?
Yeah.
Is that how he sounds like a Warcraft
3? I think so. Well, at least a bit similar.
Either I gotta listen to that again or you gotta practice more. For guys who have just tuned in wondering why the hell we're casting CLG versus EG, it actually wasn't by choice in the end. Moscow 5 versus DK was meant to be played out. We're inside the game. We started off. DK are currently playing up against bots to fill the gap.
Nothing else to do. Play against bots.
In the replay. So, DK are currently playing up against bots. And Moscow 5 have forfeit both their games. up against DK. That is the reason why we jumped. You can't hear us in Dota TV because CLG versus EG started and we jumped onto the back of Dota TV. So you wouldn't be bored for 2 hours. You wouldn't just sit here for 2 hours and go doop 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 doop. Instead, you go, yeah, 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 Elisa!
It's the best cast in the world.
Really?
I think it is.
I don't know. I think we dropped in quality of late, man.
We have?
Yeah, we got to raise the bar, man. It's like the high jump of Dota.
Fine. What do you think of the Queen of Pain pick, by the way? I haven't really... I think it's a bit weird. Enigma is such a great counter to Blink heroes in general. And at the same time, Lone Druid, one Entangle, and you're basically really, really, really screwed. Yeah, I'm looking at the chat now. It's absolutely hilarious.
Tech support is needed.
Help, help.
Is somebody on call in Valve? You know Valve have masseuse on call?
They do?
Yeah, at any time, if you ever need, like, a massage, all you gotta do is just basically go down to the room. Sometimes they are there during a certain period of the day. Uh-huh. And if they're not, then you just give them a call, and they'll run straight over and give you a massage. Uh-huh. That was the one thing I didn't do when I was at Valve.
That's pretty bad. Well, Vinal is saying incoming, so yeah. We hope to be fixing that problem
very soon. The mouse issue again. It was happening yesterday, and... Yeah, they're actually playing on the same bank of computers.
Yeah.
So that's probably the main reason why the problem is pretty local.
But all of the players are actually bringing in their own mice as well as keyboard.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm not quite sure what the problem is. Maybe it's actually that.
You bring in your own mouse and keyboard and things get complicated. Happens all the time. Yeah. All the time.
It's not really great. I still remember with 357 actually because he didn't read the sheet about... not being able to plug in PS2 connections, and he just brought in both all of his SteelSeries keyboard with both PS2s. That just didn't bloody work. I actually went with him to Hvost and actually borrowed it in his Hvost keyboard for him because it was the only one also who was using the same SteelSeries keyboard.
Really?
So yeah. He couldn't really get used to that Razer keyboard because of those weird ass keys there on the left side, but yeah.
Mm-hmm. And... So we do have a pause right now while we're waiting for EG to try and work out a couple of problems for themselves. Just to say right now, too, we've got our first team our first two teams that have completed all of their games now, DK and Moscow 5.
Yeah, well done. Congratulations. Well,
we can say that. So DK finished their Group A on 11-3, yep. And Moscow 5 finished their Group 2-12. So in this scenario, they were always going to be lower bracket. Even if they won their two games, they couldn't get on top of Evil Geniuses, who are currently 6-6. There's actually the big reason behind this game, which we're now going to set up again. Both Canalogic Gaming and Evil Geniuses are both 6-6.
Yeah, and if they actually draw in this one, who knows?
We will have a playoff. Yeah. We'll have a playoff match. Depending on what's going to happen, because they'll go 7-7, and if Zenith lose both their games, then we have a three-way tie in Group A over the third, fourth, and fifth position. And then the playoff games will come up directly after today's games. As far as Group B goes, I was talking to Holy Master, and he was actually saying there's a possibility for a five-way tie. At this point, Na'Vi, Tongfu, and Orange, and sorry, it's already on a four-way tie, Anyhome, are all 6-6.
If all of them draw, because Na'Vi plays against Tongfu, Orange plays against Ehome, and Complexity at the same time lose both the matches,
yep.
It's a five-way tie.
Yep. And then Group B gets interesting.
It already is pretty interesting, to be honest, because I got the feeling that those four teams that are currently on the tie, their power level is roughly equal. So it's all about this day if they can make something really happen and take a 2-0. Mm-hmm. Whoever takes 2-0 advances, it's that simple. On the other hand, you don't really want to land on the fourth position there, because and that would mean you were going to face up against LGD in the winner bracket.
That is actually true. That should be the way it works.
It was an automatic ticket nearly to actually get sent to the lower bracket.
Well, then again, you know what? This is the world of Dota, and some of us, while we might have had hello, Universe, he's playing around with, he actually steals the Impish rune from Lacoste. Oh, and he's body blocking Lacoste as well.
So to get some damage in, why not?
It's beautiful, man. It's beautiful. It's like, what are you going to do, Lacoste? What are you going to do? You've got an invisible force fighting you, and a bear's got more life points than you do. Challenge accepted.
Yeah. Interesting enough, we actually haven't really talked about which player is playing what, so I'm just going to quickly run over to EJ. It will be Melk, the captain, and was he drafting this summer? I believe he was.
Yeah, he is drafting.
He's drafting. So on that Enigma going into the woods. We're gonna have Bulba on the Invoker that he loves so much. We're playing Quas Wegs with Blades of Attack first, very, very simple. Going solo mid up against Misery's Queen of Pain. Bot lane will be Fierce Lone Druid.
Man, bottom lane, you gotta check
looks
this.
Like we're gonna have a little bit of a go down, like us.
They can't kill him. Nah. They can't kill him yet.
That bear is just still too low level. Universe, as already mentioned, being on that Shadow Demon. And a Demon, who is playing a Boots First Coddle and stacking the small creep camp to actually farm.
This is actually quite smart. In the end, it is still going to be an off-lane Keeper of the Light, which was what I called. It's because Demon, he likes doing this role. He likes taking the off-lane Coddle. But the problem is, he needs level 2. He needs to have Chakra. And once he's got Chakra, then he can stand on the top lane by himself. Hello, Misery. Low on life in the middle lane.
He's actually gone for that Shadow Strike first and then Screen of Pain. So no level in Blink, which is actually very, very dangerous to do. He already popped off the self to survive. So that means his bottle is going to be shipped over to him just in time there. Mm-hmm. But still no Blink on him. And Bulba is just looking with the Wex on level 2. Which also, he's taking some damage on Misery.
Yeah, it's going to be a fun little trade between the two of them. But Bulba's going to be a little bit more cautious with himself because Misery's just going to be around the bottom, which means easy burst damage continuously coming out, plus having the life regen, where Bulba's walking around with Quas Wex. Sure, he's got his regen up from the Quas, but while he's running for phase boots, he's going to be a lot more cautious with his life points. Now, Universe with a haste rune wants to run towards mid lane. He's going to dive on top of the tower. There goes the disruption, but nobody really wants to follow this off, and Demon's in no position for it. In fact, he just gives Chakra to Bulba, and it's now going to head up towards his top lane after he dewards, obviously. But Pycat's free farming up top lane.
Miss? Nope. Okay.
Lacoste. On the run. There's no entangle yet. And this is Lacoste's upside right now. Harassment will push him off the bot lane, and that means he won't get as much experience, but they can't kill him unless he overextends.
Yep. The Battle of the Carries is obviously commencing.
Oh, Misery!
Yep, seeing it.
Bulba
doing a solo.
He was able to actually use Tornado to set that little sucker up.
Nah, he's using Cold Snap first and then switching to Tornado, since before Invoke level 2, you can only have one spell invoked at all times. Mm-hmm. So that was very, very good perception there. Incredibly overconfident there by Misery. I think that the main reason is that he put that one out into Shadow Strike, which is really good against melee heroes, but against a fast running Invoker, it probably is not the best sort of option, since he can trade hits with you. He doesn't care about the slow. And the damage is not that significant.
No.
Well, ENG get the first blood. And that's also giving them a 1,000 gold advantage. I'm really surprised they got such an advantage. I suppose they are running the Enigma, and Miracle's doing what he can by trying to pull the creep waves down all the time and control that top lane completely. The Demon, he's still finding levels from inside the jungle. Melka's up to level 4. It's amazing how many levels EG is pulling out of the jungle. It's amazing how much farm they're pulling out of the jungle as well.
Yeah, Demon looks to be heading towards the top lane now. He can't really do much against the Pycat's Morphling. No, he's just controlling the rune. And so since Queen of Pain is running their bottom lane, Invoker certainly is not, so just give it to the support.
Mm-hmm. Demon's still going to go top at one point. Unless he was fearful of giving away first blood, but that's now past.
And once again, Kelson popping off on Misery, just copping so much damage there by Bulba.
Bulba's Invoker is definitely a sight. Misery, he still wants to stay in close. He still wants all these last hits. At this point,
oh, look at that. Smoke Gang going to come in there from Akias with Miracle. They're probably going to find Demon there.
Yeah, Demon with a double damage rune, but it's not really going to help him if he's going to get Burrow Strike. Are they going to get the timing right? Telekin, he just now follow with the Burrow Strike and right click it down. Misery blinks to the screen to ensure the last hit in.
It's a very, very important.
And then Bulba is just like opening misery. Keep it rolling, and he gets him too.
Yep, he blinked in. So level 1 blink, having a very, very high cooldown. So in the end, the effort that Seal just putting into getting that kill on Demons is not really paying off there.
Bottom lane, yep. We're going to see Universe and Lacoste going. This bear does have Entangle. If he does manage to latch it, 2 swipes and can't get it.
So he won't get the kill. Blocked off by the Shadow Demon Illusion, which is a bit unfortunate. Orb of Venom also up on the bear, plus Boots. So Fear
Miracle
really
and Aki.
The build.
They've rotated down bot lane. They're seeing trying to catch that Universe while he's retreating. Lacoste, he's not level 6.
Oh, Entangle!
The chance, man, the chance. They're still going to pull Universe back in for the Burrow Strike, but the right click's coming out by Fear. He's able to pick him up. Universe still on low life, then turns around for disruption, plus the catcher. Bear can focus on Aki. Lone Druid, well, he's got one, he won't get two. TP's already gone back to base.
Yeah, so in the end, CLG is really, and everything is not really paying off for them. They're seeing that one hit stuff flying out there.
It's kind of been weird, man. Like, with these two teams, with all the teams really in the international, I think a lot of us got very, very disheartened with a lot of the teams going, you know what, I just don't think they can win. Like, EG on their first day, I think a lot of people were very, very iffy about their chances in this. And then, second day, a little bit more luck. Challenger Gaming also a little bit of up and down in this. But for me, when I watch this game, there's plays being made by everybody on the map. And CLG, yeah, EG, they're having great fun in the mid. They're having great fun on the bot. But CLG on that top lane, Pycat, he's getting the farm on the top lane and a farmed up Morphling. We've seen it so many times during this competition. There's always that ace up the sleeve, which is that hard carry on the top lane. I'm waiting for Misery to die right now. Cold Snap combining with Laser. And then the Tornado a little bit off target. Misery jumping down a little bit further instead of going straight back. But really, EG and CLG, these are two teams when I watch them play up against each other. I don't think there's any point of the game when I would physically say, even if we're 2,000 gold behind and 3,000 worth of experience behind, I'm not going to say that CLG is out of this or EG is out of this. These two teams, they can easily come back from anything.
Certainly, we have a free farm Morphling, and we know how big he can get. On the other hand, though, there's also free farming Silabeau at the same time, who picked up a kill. Don't you boost his economy, so 1.5k plus.
Top lane gank. Miracle as well as Aki. They're just throwing down the ward for now, but they need the creep wave, and Demon is
dead.
Just like, yeah, okay, what am I going to do? Sandstorm, Burrow Strike, Telekinesis going not really at the right time.
Really bad, no.
The chain didn't work properly.
The chain was incredibly bad for them. That was a 100% kill there for CLG, but Radiant's they messed it up completely. Also a bit weird that Miracle was going for the Sandstorm. I mean, Coddle already has Tranquil Boots. He's running really, really fast. There's really no point in going for the Sandstorm first, and one auto hit would just suffice.
Could just be a misclick, unless he was worrying about mana leak or something like that.
No, I'm not sure, but of course, I think misclick at this high level Melk. Game is the most.
Bot lane.
Yeah.
There is going to be some fun on the top lane in a moment, but it's Lacoste in the bot lane. Melk with Black Hole. Starts off with the Malifaux stun. Don't know if he'll pop the hole for this little second there. They got the catcher. In fact, the catcher was taken by the boar, so Lacoste able to run away a little bit further. And, well. Beastmaster does go down the end at the same time. The Coddle goes on the top lane. Looks like Bulb was here as well. TP support, is it going to be coming in? Tornado misses on Miracle, but he's forced to take out that tower too much. Wonderful sell by Miracle. Keeps him alive on 25 HP. Bulba, he's got nothing left. Cold Snap in 6 seconds, but that right click on Aki really hurting. And then his own creep is blocking him. Then Pycat blocks Aki. Oh, he picked up the wrong one. He picked up the range creep and not Bulba.
I think that was intentional, actually. I think he wanted to pull the creep and then throw it onto Bulba so Bulba gets stunned. But,
you get the stun anyway if you pick him up.
Exactly.
Or at least the disable time.
Not quite sure about this. I think just Aki's movement has been really, really off so far.
And his first game of the day, man. 9 a.m. on day 3 after you've been playing two very, very long days of Dota.
Yeah.
It starts to wear on you, but EG and both CLG and EG, they've both got a lot of experience on land.
Exactly, since Aki is also one of the longest Dota players. He did switch to a game that that must not be named, of course, but he now finally came back.
So he played Rise of Nations?
I guess. We could ask him. Yeah, well, let's interview him in Seattle if he actually did play it.
I actually enjoyed Rise of Nations. It was a fun game.
I never played it, actually.
Really?
Yeah, I haven't played many games.
It was great when all you need is just like one guy in the front and then you just tech rush at the back.
I don't actually know even what kind of game that was. To my big shame, I have to admit.
Maybe it's classic for everybody out there who knows that era of games.
Possibly. And Demon is now using buying up the Quelling Blade to find those spots for Illuminate. I'm not quite sure if this is really worth it, though, but it's cool.
He sets up. Demon, I've noticed, he spent a lot of time. I don't know if he's just been researching it or not, but I'm always finding him moving into unusual positions that no one would really think of. He does it with his Tidehunter, he's now doing it with his Coddle. So I'm wondering if, like Malk just set him down and said, here is fantastic positions you can use on the map. Give her a shot, try different things that you can, so you're able to leech off experience or at least get a nice little blast off, catch somebody out of position. Do all that kind of stuff. But Demon's always been a jungle player.
Always and kind of loves it. He loves those kind of juke spots.
We have flashbacks to his puck from the International 1 when he was jumping around on the top of the die lane.
Yeah, that was really, really good play there by him, of course. And Demon, though, he should be very careful, but Miracle is just not fast enough. Tranquil Boots plus the innate high movement speed of the Caudal give him 300. He's currently on 395, so essentially 400 MS. But dual smoke once again popping off there from CRG. That's a third smoke, I believe.
Well, where are they going to gank? They're going to try and bring down Bulba. Bulba's been having a great time in that mid lane. He's got four stun as well as phase boost, so catching him out is not going to be easy.
No, I actually don't think they can get him. He's too tanky and too mobile at the moment.
You see his movement speed. He's almost clocking up to the 400. In fact, he is. And now in comes Aki. He needs to get that telekinesis, but Bulba doing the really wise move. He's sitting down low on the mid lane, and he knows the gank can come from the top. So Miracle and Aki have no opening until he comes up, and now Melk and Universe come in with smoke. So now Bulba will make the move. Aki is visible, and Melk just like, give me a smorgasbord! Then the black hole! Burrow struck away by Miracle, getting himself out of range, but Aki is left to take the brunt of the EG attack. And makes it 6-2 now, but four star up. They're chasing. Tornado catches up on Miracle. Spin him up. There's the Burrow strike, back up to the high ground. Miracle, so maneuverable is that SK.
It's a very, very good play by Miracle to get out, but once again, make it 62 and invoke on a dominating streak so far. 4-0 and 48 last hits. Misery is actually now being out there sitting and using Scream to constantly do it. But on the other hand, that Invoker is really, really big already. And he just TP'd towards bot lane to go to look for Lacoste.
Hey, might better get him too. Lacoste and run back. Lacoste still at level 6. Call snap. He wants an entangle from the bear. First one.
Oh,
and
first
he gets it.
Entangle.
And Fear is just like, I thank you, sir. 7-2.
Sometimes fate just doesn't work out for you during the day.
A random chance, man. Random chance.
It's incredibly annoying. At the same time, Pykett is farming really well in the Morphling. But
he got the last hit in that top tower as well when he brought it down.
Yeah. Since but Fear is still doing the same and he's got two assists as well, so he has enough gold for the Relic if he wants to just go for it. Quite sure if he wants to go for Meltem or for Relic, but I think in this situation, Relic is really, really good.
Surprising though, gold starting to balance up with that one tower going down, but the experience still keeps going up. 5k going the way now of CLG. EG. What am I talking about?
The four man smoke. They want pie cap. It's going to be very difficult to get though.
Well, they got no black hole, and the lockdown, you disrupt him, you'll just wave straight back out of it, so they got to instantly EMP burn him. So he's out of mana, but even then, I don't think that EMP is going to be strong enough. So there goes the EMP, but waveform away. He's going to start strength morphing. Aki's going to come in as well. TP support's going to come to support him. Connell Blast will go. Wonderful Fade Boss through all of EG. They've got no damage whatsoever now.
I really think that was kind of a weird decision as well. He did go for the Purge. I mean, it does have higher casting range. But at the same time, I think the disruption might have just been enough time though for the EMP to pop off. Just trying to kill a Morphling at this stage of the game with four people and without Black Hole is so difficult.
Well, they're going to try and defend the top lane. Lacoste going to TP up. Welcome to your 5-on-5. Actually, it's only a 4v5. Misery's still here in the middle lane. He's got a TP scroll, so he can join the fight if he needs to.
It's a 3v5, really.
Oh, there's a Morphling replicate, so he can jump back.
He's
healing up.
One.
And jump.
Nope.
No, let's go.
No jump. Tower's already down, and Laundry's going and picks up the last hit. So that's nearly a full Radiance done for him.
We kind of forget about Fear sometimes. I know we're talking about it a lot during like the JD Masters as well as the defense, which was basically, for me, my lead up to the International. And Fear, he's just been showing superb timing when it comes to last hits. To a point where there are very few that can keep up with him. The fact that Morphling is keeping up at 80 for 36. It's mainly because Pycast just had free space. He's been left on a free lane by himself, where at least Fears had the Beastmaster causing him some form of issue. And also Beastmaster finally level 6, and he's ancient stacking now. Sol Ring ancient stacking.
It's the best.
Oh, a miracle!
I'm seeing it.
Last right click. Bulba able to claim it up and then stick charging so he can have a little bit of extra mana. And I think there's also a bit of Chakra coming out from Demon.
Also, it's interesting to see he's going for that Void Stone, so possibly Direct Hex or Yule Scepter. I don't know what he wants to go for. Yule Scepter, I'm kind of thinking what could be Yule's really, really good. Probably to cancel the Linkins that Morphling's building up. And so he's going to be running on max movement speed all the time, so that's pretty good. Fear those. That's this creep wave plus another one, he's got his Radiance.
And that's a dangerous time for CLG. Radiant's Bear push. He's already got enough damage behind the Bear from just Relic and Pycat. Has some fun with Bulba, but waveformed in, which means he can't get away from that EMP, and Pycat's completely out of mana now. He's got 4-1 charges up his sleeve if he wants to use it. But Bulbur is also pretty low as well.
Yeah, but then close to being out of mana, and Fear now has the Radiance being delivered up to him. Really, really good farm there on him, of course, and actually putting it on his... Oh, okay, he's probably still going to put it on the bear afterwards. It's just easier for the transfer thing on the courier.
How's Demon been going? Staff?
Four staff, most likely.
I would assume that as well, but I'm wondering if it's even going to be Necro books. If they feel the need to push a little bit earlier on. I would have actually thought he'd go mech. But who is actually... No, I've already got mech up for Melk. And Fear, he's already got Radiance now. Does he try and go the hood for the team?
He's gonna at least buy Planeswalkers, Chloe, considering Askez was Queen of Pain, that huge LE combo.
Mm-hmm.
But still not quite sure about it. I think Fear is still gonna wants to go for the quicker Arcane Boots.
Mystery, might have a little bit of fun here with Demon.
Yeah, good luck with that, he's got Tranquil Boots. Just a little bit of harassment doesn't really help against the Total there.
We're currently seeing the tier 1 tower trying to be brought down bot lane, but Spirit Bear's currently got the Fade Bolt on it, which means pushing that tower takes a lot longer than it normally would.
How's Piker going to be doing? He's still actually quite some time off there. Doesn't even have his ultimate orb yet. He's going to have it after this creep wave, but still, Lincoln's going to come in fairly late. So fairly that he's still leading in terms of last hit and denies, but still, only one kill for him at the moment.
EG's forming up bottom lane. Got a tier 1 tower to push down. And looks like support is coming in. Misery is here. Aki's also in the neighborhood. Shadow Poison just trying to have a little bit of a scout deeper into the bottom lane.
Lone Druid once again. It's so easy to get the last hit with both Better Cry as well as the Spirit Breath Demolish on.
Mm-hmm. TLG are going to defend the tier 2.
Just look at the damage that Misery is just copying from the Radiance there. It's so annoying.
Now staying close, man. Now he's getting cold snapped up, forced to blink away. Demon also with a little bit of a laser over the top of Misery. Just so much harassment of the Queen of Pain. At the same time, Morphling is going to be pushing that tier 2 tower while this is happening. It's costing EG a lot more players on this bot lane to do this. But Misery is thinking about going and then blinks away again. Blast again, and look at the damage. Misery's so damn low.
They can't really defend it. And Bulbul just... yeah, he actually did manage to pop with the cold snap, but that was
it. But Pinecat's going to take tier 2 tower on the top lane.
Is he?
There's no fortification. TP, double's going to come in. Pycat able to take it. Bulbur attempted the deny then.
Didn't look like it, though. He was attacking the Morphling in the end. It was a bit of a misclick there. But still, CLG do not really get the better trade-off, but it's still not too bad for them. Misery actually blinking in there on Melk.
Hey, jumps right in the middle of Melk. Misery's a miracle's here as well.
And
might
dangle.
Be thinking, there goes, man. Just timing is not going right for CLG. Aki going to be burned out right now. EMP doesn't burn enough, but Bulbur keeps up with him. So wicked sick for Bulbur, and 2 heroes down for CLG. This is opening for EG, 19 minutes in, to push down to the tier 3 tower. Fortification will slow them down. Lacoste also trying to get rid of this creep wave, but...
Good luck with that.
Yeah, they're having trouble. They're having a lot of trouble. New one now arrives, and while there's a creep wave there, that's all Fear needs so we can beat down the tower. Pycat getting cold snapped up. There goes the tower. Now focusing onto the racks, 19 minutes in. And EG, man, they're looking very, very good to hit the first blow in this first game. Miracle, he wants to get position for a good epicenter. There's 2-3, Malk is still here, he's still got Black Hole up. The bear hasn't finished the racks just yet. There goes Tornado trying to catch up the SK, which it does do so. Back onto the racks, merely does go down. Now they can quickly take down the range racks as well if they want to stick around. I don't know if they will though. Nope, we're going to fall back. They're happy, they didn't lose any heroes, and they took a racks, and they took 2 heroes before they started.
Yeah, it's really, really good. And I think it has to do something with the Queen of Pain pick. Queen of Pain cannot outlane Invoker mid if he decides to go for Quas Wax. Mm-hmm. And at the same time, just doesn't fit into the lineup that CLG really have. Pycat's finding farm everywhere, but he will have enough gold for his Lincolns right now. Still not enough, though.
Mm.
As in, you have a Morphling with Lincoln Sphere, but how good is that? Can't really fight. Doesn't even have that much damage at the moment.
Well, Bulba finding a couple of Pycats. Not the real one, though. He's currently walking around in the Invis rune.
So it took up a surprising amount of large amount of damage here from him, but he's probably just going to switch to Quas and be fine with it. And yes, indeed, he's going to go for that really, really early hex.
Ah.
Mystic stuff. Who is that on top lane? It's only the bear. It's going to annoy the living crap out of Pyke if he can't kill it.
Demon's going to give some amends towards bot lane, but Misery's going to see if he can solo him up. There's the Blink Scream. Needs to follow up with Sting, and nah, even though he doesn't have enough damage, and instant TP out by Demon. Heading in towards the mid lane. So EG, once again, I like this from a team that, like, you've got Lone Druid. You've got what you need to push down towers. Do you just keep farming? Do you sit in the back? Do you just say, well, we're already ahead, let's just stay ahead? They say, no, if CLG are to engage, just not a problem. But we're still going to push on their towers. We're going to fight where we can at least gain some map control.
Dire's middle tower. So what's it buying up? The one cloak, which is owned by Dire's Fear. But where did all his fallen. Other gold go? There's nothing new on the bear or on himself.
He didn't buy back either. He didn't lose the money there.
And he's got a lot of
gold. Aki, Cole Snap stun on him, and maybe it will be enough to bring him down. Sorry, Malphus stun, and he just burns. Keeper of the Light able to get the last hit, and then Tornado also picks up Lacoste. Back out makes the secret shot, but T1 tower down, T2 tower now following. And the bottom lane still pushing out. Misery is trying to counter push this, while Morphling's trying to take out the top lane and try and force EG to TP back. But EG at this point, they're sitting at a point that they can take mid tower if they wanted to. Bulba's the one to defend it. And now Lacoste and Miracle. War as well as Epicenter should not be overestimated. Cole's just bringing him back. He's just going to return. Like, Invoker can go up. Actually, no, Invoker got attacked.
Yeah, he got attacked by the Warbling, I think.
Because the return started. And this could be a bit of a problem. Lacoste now looks for the Roar, goes on Demon of all people. And then Disruption by Universe keeps him up. There's the Purge, there's the Catcher. Misery coming down as well. And Aki's currently running away from the bear, and they'll be able to kill this little guy off. But Lone Druid has a resummon, which he will now do.
Where did all this gold go? I'm so confused right now. Fear had so much gold.
It's a hood, it's a full hood.
Plus, it's a pipe.
Yeah.
Does he have a branch on himself?
He's got three branches on himself.
Well, okay, that's gonna be a full pipe.
He just needs money for the ring. So then he can have the full item.
Nice attempt to deny the Misery. He does have a BKB, but that's not going to help you at all. You're not dealing any damage. That's the main problem.
He already has to stop walking around. Demon just fires in and lets the mana leak off. And then Misery thinks about jumping in. Look for the Epicenter to come. It might come in time. BKB on Misery. There's the waveform down. Try and bring down Melk on the side of play. There's still no SK in range for something. And Melk can't find a good opening either. EMP goes another guy. Spyro strike straight through one. Gets on a Bulba. And Miracle does take a fall in the end. He tried to get his Epicenter off during that, but unable to do so. Now up towards the high ground. Misery as well as Lacoste hiding up there. But EG still can push through the main base. There's no tower.
Yeah, Melk TP's back to base to region a little bit. Demon is going to recall him at the same time, so there he goes again. Close to full HP, so Enigma.
And there goes mid-Rax. EG hitting hard, and CLG just can't find an opening and bike out. What else can I do? Intercept the creep wave away from the heroes is all he can really do now.
It's very, very funny, but still. Where is EG are going to take this game for sure. That's two Raxes down in 23 minutes in. Very little that they can do. Aki's performance has been really, really off. It was his own fault that they missed two really crucial kills. It could have been.
You're talking about Demon on the top lane?
Yeah, Demon on the top lane once, and where he used the telekinesis too late, and Bulba on the other hand. I was running away. And Demon just going for two vitality boosts just to be a dick.
Whatever keeps him alive.
At this stage of the game, it doesn't matter what items Coddle goes for. You could buy it once, more, try to buy a Dagon 5 if you really want to.
Pycat just sniped the Radiant Courier.
He's currently just running the really, really weird plays. Lone Druid picks up the Aegis of the Immortal. And they're going to rotate top, I should imagine.
Yep, tier 2 tower and then push through the last lane. That's all they really need to do. Pycat now TPing out at the same time. Malk's going to make his move in. And Malk probably should have heard that TP as he's walking down.
It's probably a bit annoying for him, but Malk also finishing up the Necromonicon. And what's Demon? He did build the 4 staff with the Staff of Wizardry.
Yeah, 4 staff for him. We got, what, level 2 Necro books up on Enigma. We got Sign of the Vice 4 staff for the Invoker. We got Pipe and Vlad's up on Fear, plus the Radiance on top of the Bear. EG have all their essential items. Pycat, well, he does have himself 1.7k in a Lincoln Sphere, but that's basically it. There's Mech up on the Beastmaster. Blink Dagger up on Miracle now. So big item for him to try to finally get, and Queen of Pain with that BKB which he had during the last engagements.
But, 4 men smoke.
Yeah, it's gonna take one hell of a fight now by CLG to turn this momentum around, and they're gonna start to get burned up by the bear. But they still want to go top lane, and they're gonna find Fear. Bear gets pulled back in again. They drop the ward. Lacoste is showing up, and Fear just starts up on Lacoste. Doesn't get the entangle after two swipes. Four star down. There's the entangle on the third swipe. And Misery can just stand there and watch his teammate die. In comes the epicenter. Nice hit as well. Combining with the Quap ulti. Kills off the Shadow Demon. But the stability, the mech plus the pipe, is just too much. And CLG lose three. Misery is out of mana. He's trying to run himself away faster than this, but. Three heroes down, EG lost one, and they can push through very, very easily. Tier 2 tower takes a fall now, tier 3 will follow.
Yeah, and Rax will follow on that one. No epicenter, no Queen of Queen ultimate. There's very little they can do.
They at least got their combo off at the end.
They did.
That combo timing in the end did work. The problem was, they didn't...
Shadow Demon.
Yeah, all they got was SD, and they didn't find the right position for it. Like, Lacoste was there, and he didn't want Shadow Demon to start with. Now Lacoste, burned out of mana, nice Burrow Strike, gonna go through three, Scream as well. Ward was just stolen, Roar goes out on Bulba. Aki, he ended up actually, he stole the EMP out of all things, then Malk pops the Black Hole. No one's really left alive in that one, Queen of Pain buys back, Pycat looking for a couple of kills. Misery also blinks up, gets a Scream out in one, so buyback by the Invoker. Malk will go down, Pycat being focused down by Fear. Bulba now getting pulled back in again by Coddle, so Misery has to fight Bulba all over again. Buybacks galore, Aki now tries to retreat, and they might think about having a crack at, well, at least Bulba. They can't bring down Fear. Misery comes back in again, Scream to go. Misery, a Piglet, and getting Cole snapped up at the same time, so he does go down. Miracle jumps out the Sandstorm. Nice tornado there by Bulba, even better prediction there by Miracle. Just trying to run away, but he's out of mana, cannot blink away. Pycat trying to go back again on Bulba, but not really going to happen in this scenario. Way forward towards the high ground, get back in range of that tower. But Fear, so easily able to tank it up there. Malk has returned towards the top lane as well, bringing his mech in tow, and triggers up the Lincoln Sphere. But the top tower should take a fall. At least CLG putting up a bit of a fight. GG is called by Pycat. But I think this little last moment from CLG is them saying, you know what, EG, you take game one, but game two is a whole new playing field. Let's go again.
This is the best thing that CLG should do, basically just completely forget about the game one and just start anew from game two. So retain the chances of sort of going into the playoffs. The tiebreaker matches.
That is true. So EG, well, they managed to get themselves a secure spot in the top four, or will CLG force it to a draw and maybe actually force the playoff matches to come up directly after our second round of matches today as well? For those guys wondering why EG versus CLG, well, the main reason for that one is Moscow 5 forfeit both their games. That's the reason why we're covering this
just
one.
Just to annoy us.
Because they love us.
They love us.
It's because they love us. Yeah. All right, guys. We'll be back here in a couple moments. Game 2 EG versus CLG coming up for you.